In this tutorial, we will walk through setting up a custom nozzle in the DirectCommand ISOBUS Liquid Module. Nozzle specifications are required for several features of the DirectCommand ISOBUS Liquid Module to work. These features include pressure-based control, pressure fallback, droplet size monitoring, and pressure and flow relationship monitoring. To begin, you will need to be on the run screen of the DirectCommand ISOBUS Liquid Module in the Universal Terminal. Tap the wrench on the right side of the screen, then tap Manage Components. On the bottom, tap the Nozzles tab. Here you can view existing nozzles and their parameters, if any have already been added. To add a new nozzle, tap the green plus. There are two nozzle setup methods, either enter all parameters manually or select a standard ISO nozzle. For this example, we will enter all parameters manually and tap the next arrow. The first step is to give the nozzle a name. We will add a nozzle that represents a Turbo T-Jet TT11004. For the nozzle parameters, we will need to consult the chart produced by the nozzle manufacturer. For our desired target rate of 12 gallons per acre and at a speed of 10 miles per hour, our reference pressure will be 40 psi. At 40 psi, the capacity of the nozzle is 0.4 gallons per minute. The nozzle has a working pressure range of 15 psi minimum to a 90 psi maximum. Once those values are entered, tap the next arrow. On this screen, we will enter what the minimum pressures are for each droplet size. The Turbo T-Jet TT11004 nozzle is capable of extra coarse to medium droplet sizes. If the nozzle is not capable of a droplet size, leave the pressure blank for that size. Once all of the applicable droplet sizes are entered, tap the next arrow. We can now select a color for the nozzle. We recommend choosing the same color as the physical nozzle, so you can easily identify later whether the correct nozzle is selected as being active. Tap the green check. Now that all specifications for the nozzle have been entered, we need to set it as the active nozzle for our configuration. There are two places that this can be done. First, from the Universal Terminal screen, tap the nozzle icon. From the dropdown, select the nozzle that is currently installed on the sprayer boom. Then tap the running man to return to the run screen. Note how it shows the name and color of the active nozzle, and the nozzle's specified droplet size ranges are now shown on the pressure gauge. If you move to the Ag Leader mapping screen, you'll see that the active nozzle also appears here. The second place to select an active nozzle is on the mapping screen. Begin by tapping the settings wrench on the right side of the screen, then tap the nozzle icon. From the list of available nozzles, tap the nozzle that is currently installed on the sprayer boom, and then tap the green check. Tap the back arrow to return to the mapping screen. The name and color of the active nozzle appear beside the pressure gauge, which now shows the nozzle's specified droplet size ranges. If you view the Universal Terminal screen, you will see that the same nozzle is selected as active. You will now be able to set up a nozzle profile in the DirectCommand ISOBUS Liquid Module so you can use features like pressure-based control and droplet size monitoring. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.